Good morning, all students. We will discuss about the ELISA. ELISA is the enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, or is a type of immunoassay. So before we discuss about the ELISA, we revise some definitions or just some immunology terms like immunoassay. So what is immunoassay? Immunoassay is an assay which is based on the reaction of an antigen with an antibody which is specific for that antigen. So what is antigen? Antigen, you all know about it, that is the substance which is capable of interacting with an antibody and stimulate the production of an antibody with which it reacts specifically. Then what is antibody? Antibodies are the immunoglobulin class of molecules that binds specifically to an antigen or heptin. Heptin is not a complete antigen. So heptin is a substance which itself cannot produce antibody, but when conjugated to an immunogenic carrier, it stimulates the synthesis of antibody. So it needs an immunogenic carrier to act as an antigen and stimulate the antibody production. So what is analyte? Analyte is a sample which we have analyzed, or we have to determine the contents of antigen or antibody in the sample by this immunoassay technique. Okay, so ELISA is a type of immunoassay. There is so much type of assays. Before the ELISA, we have used some types. Like VIA is a radio immunoabsorbent assay, is a technique in a radio emitting material or a radio material use. So it is hazardous to health. So now we have used in place of this radio emitting material, we have to use the enzyme. So the name is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, means the antigen or the antibody is labeled with a enzyme instead of a radio emitting material. Because of this radiological hazards, ELISA is a better technique than the RIA, and it is also a cheap technique than the RIA. So this is the structure of an normal antibody. An antibody contains two types of chain. We all know about it. This one is the light chain and this is the heavy chain. And these bonds are the disulfide bonds in between the heavy and the light chain, as well as the between the heavy chains. This is the FAB domain. FAB domain means the fragment antigen binding domain, in which the antigen binding sites are present, and the antigen, the part of the antigen is called the epitope, which is bind to this antigen binding sites of the antibody. And this part is the FC domain, which is called as the FC region, is fragment crystallizable regions. So before we have to discuss this antigen antibody reaction, we have to know about this FAB and the FC domain, and the antigen contains the epitopes. Because these enzyme linked immunosorbent assays or the ELISA is mainly based upon the antigen antibody reactions. So it is an immunological technique, but it is conjugated with the enzyme, so it is called as enzyme linked immunosorbent assays. So what is the contents? In the contents, we have to start with the introduction, principle, types of ELISA, applications, advantages, disadvantages, and conclusion with the summary. So we have to start with the introduction of ELISA. ELISA is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Use technique for detection of antigen or antibody. The technique was developed in 1971 by Peter Perlman and Eva Engel at Stockholm University, Sweden. A technique to prepare something like immunosorbent material, which is used to fix antigen or antibody to the surface of a container. And this container contains about 96 to 100 microwells in which this immunosorbent material is placed, and this immunosorbent material is very, very adhered to this immunoglobulin means antibodies as well as antigens. So the principle of ELISA is, the basic principle of the ELISA is based on the formation of the antigen antibody complex. So which is detected by a chromogenic detection using enzyme conjugated secondary antibody. It means when enzyme is linked either to antigen or antibody, and when this antigen antibody reaction take place, this enzyme is present over antigen or antibody, we have to use some substrate after that, and this substrate is catalyzed by this enzyme which is present over antibody or antigen and produces a some coloring product which have to analyze by, already you have to know it, that absorbance by this ELISA plate reader, aur usse aap ye detect kar paoge कि कितने अमाउंट में, अगर आपने आपका जो सैंपल ऑफ इंटरेस्ट है उसमें आपने एंटीजन डिटेक्ट करना है, कोई वायरस, कोई बैक्टीरिया, कोई मेटाबोलाइट, कोई प्रोटीन, वो आप डिटेक्ट कर सकते हैं, और आपको किसी पेशेंट के सैंपल में एंटीबॉडी डिटेक्ट करनी है कि उस पेशेंट में डिजीज के बाद कौन सी एंटीबॉडी डेवलप हुई या एंटीबॉडीज का कितना लेवल है, वो आपने डिटेक्ट करना है, उसको आप डिटेक्ट कर सकते हो बाय दिस ELISA है. सो दिस कॉन्जुगेटेड एंजाइम acts on a specific substrate is called the chromogenic substrate and generates a colored reaction product. This product is qualitatively means present or absent of this antigen or antibody, or quantitatively read using an ELISA plate reader. What is ELISA kits? ELISA kits are actually commercially available kits which can be conveniently used for the laboratory purpose. In this ELISA kits, mainly the enzyme conjugate which is mainly commercially used are ALP means alkaline phosphatase, HRP, horseradish peroxidase. It is a type of enzyme which is present in the horseradish, is a vegetable like material, and peroxidase enzyme containing this vegetable which is commercially used for this purpose. And G6PD, you all know about it, glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. And beta galactosidase are commonly used enzyme labels. Then IgG is the most prevalent immunochemical reagent in use. Means जो immunoglobulins या antibodies आपको use करना है, वो most commonly जो antibody है, वो है IgG. Then the ELISA technique. So what is about the ELISA technique? You don't go into the detail, but I just enumerate this: the liquid phase adsorption and the solid phase adsorption. So ELISA technique is a type of a biochemical technique and mainly used for the immunology to detect the presence of antibody as well as antigen in a cell. ELISA named so because it involves the use of immunosorbent material. Immunosorbent means an absorbing material which is specific for one of the component of the reaction, either antigen or antibody. Liquid phase adsorption, activated charcoal or the dextran coated charcoal is added directly to the reaction mixture. Then the solid phase adsorption, inner surface of the plastic tubes or wells of microtiter plate. The microtiter plate is made up of a plastic and it contains 96 to 100 microwells in which the immunosorbent material is placed, jahan pe ki aapki antigen ya antibody adsorb, वो सरफेस लिक्विड फेज में भी हो सकती है और सॉलिड फेज में. तो इन दिस माइक्रोटाइटर प्लेट्स ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक लेटेक्स बीड्स कैन बी यूज्ड. सो ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ दिस सॉलिड सपोर्ट द कैप्चर एंटीबॉडीज अटैच्ड बाय द फिजिकल एड्सॉर्प्शन और बाय द कोवेलेंट बॉन्डिंग. सो ELISA हैज बीन यूज्ड एज अ डायग्नोस्टिक टूल इन मेडिसिन एंड प्लांट पैथोलॉजी एज वेल एज इन क्वालिटी कंट्रोल चेक इन द वेरियस इंडस्ट्रीज. दिस इज अ कमर्शियल ELISA kit in which this is a microwell plate in which there is 96 to 100 microwells are present, which is coated, the surface of this microwells coated with an immunosorbent material, and these used for the absorbing for antigen or antibody depends upon the technique of ELISA we have used. So now we have discussed about the types of ELISA. It is important. First one is direct ELISA, indirect ELISA, sandwich ELISA and the commutative ELISA. So in this direct ELISA, it is used in the detection of an antigen in the given biological sample. आपको सैंपल दिया है, उसमें आपने कोई भी एंटीजन को या किसी प्रोटीन को, किसी वायरस या बैक्टीरिया को डिटेक्ट करा। तो इन अ माइक्रो टाइटर वेल्स आर इनिशियली इमोबिलाइज द एंटीजन टू द सरफेस ऑफ इम्यूनोसॉर्बेंट मटेरियल, मींस जो इम्यूनोसॉर्बेंट मटेरियल है उस पे जाके इनिशियली जो है वो एंटीजन जाके अटैच होगा और वो इमोबिलाइज होगा जो आपने डिटेक्ट करना है, डिटेक्टेड विद एन एंटीबॉडी। उसके बाद आपने एंटीबॉडी का यूज करना है विच इज स्पेसिफिक फॉर दिस टाइप ऑफ एंटीजन। So this antigen to be detected by antibody, जो ये antibody है, is linked to an enzyme conjugate, यानी कि वो enzyme से linked है, and this follows the addition of a substrate which produces the colored product detected by the ELISA detector. Look at this picture. This is our immunosorbent material. The antigen which have you interest in the which antigen is present in the sample of the patient. This antigen is adhered or adsorbed at the solid plate surface. So antigen is coated onto the wells by the passive adsorption. After that, we have to use the antibody, and this antibody is conjugated with this enzyme, and this type of enzyme you all know, ALP, horseradish peroxidase, D6PD or beta-galactosidase. So antibody conjugated with this enzyme is added and incubated with the antigen, and incubation period starts. After that, in a third step, we have to use the chromogenic substrate, which is mainly used for the HRP, जो है horseradish peroxidase है, उसके लिए TMB substrate यूज होता है, which gives the blue color after the reaction. Reaction क्या है? Enzyme catalyzes this substrate. So the substrate is specific for this enzyme and produces the colored product, which gives the signals to this ELISA plate reader, and you have to read the absorbance and give the results. What quantity of the antigen is present in the sample? So the substrate or chromophore is added and color develops of ELISA plate reader data. Why it is called as an ELISA? Because the direct ELISA is directly association between the antigen and antibody. So it is called the direct ELISA. In indirect ELISA, it is used for the detection of an antibody in the given sample. Micro titer wells are initially immobilized with antigen specific for the antibody to be detected. So antibody have to be detected. So in a micro titer well, initially immobilized with antigen. Antigens are immobilized, which is specific for the antibody to be detected. Although antigens वो हैं जिनको specifically detect करना है antibody. यहाँ पे हम क्या करेंगे कि दिस इज फॉलोड बाय द सैंपल, हमने सैंपल यूज करना है जिसमें वो प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडीज प्रेजेंट है व्हिच हैज टू बी डिटेक्टेड। सो आफ्टर दैट एंजाइम, उसके बाद आफ्टर यूजिंग दिस प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडीज वी हैव टू यूज द एंजाइम कॉन्जुगेटेड सेकेंडरी एंटीबॉडी इज एडेड, एंड दिस सेकेंडरी एंटीबॉडी अगेंस्ट द होस्ट स्पीशीज ऑफ द प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी बाइंड्स टू द प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी फॉर द डिटेक्शन। After that, the substrate which forms a colored reaction product has to be measured by the absorbance through the ELISA plate reader. Please look at the picture. This is the microwells having immunosorbent material. This is the antigen present over here. And आपने इस antigen की specific इस antibody को detect करना है, which is present in the sample of the patient, which is called as a primary antibody. उसके बाद जो एंटीजन कोटेड वेल्स है उसमें आपने पेशेंट का सैंपल यूज करना है जिसमें हम मान के चल रहे हैं कि प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी प्रेजेंट है। आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू यूज दिस सेकेंडरी एंटीबॉडी व्हिच इज एक्चुअली व्हिच इज कॉन्जुगेटेड विद दिस एंजाइम कॉन्जुगेट एचआरपी यानी कि हॉर्सरेडिश पेरोक्साइड। आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू यूज दिस टीएमबी सब्सट्रेट व्हिच इज स्पेसिफिक फॉर दिस एंजाइम एंड इट प्रोड्यूसेस द कलर प्रोडक्ट व्हिच इज यूजुअली अ ब्लू कलर। बट आफ्टर यूजिंग दिस वी हैव टू यूज अ ब्लॉकिंग सॉल्यूशन व्हिच convert this color in blue into the yellow color, and which have to be detected by this ELISA plate reader. So this is a indirect ELISA because antigen is over here and indirectly attachment of the secondary and primary antibody here. So it is called as a indirect ELISA, means ki aap directly detect nahi kar rahe, this simply ek antigen aaya, ek antibody reaction hui aur aapne detect kar liya, aap indirectly usko detect kar rahe ho using a primary as well as a secondary antibody. इसमें आपको जो ध्यान रखना है वो ये है कि यहाँ पे जो एंटीजन है वो तो आपका एंटीजन बाइंडिंग साइट पर अटैच हो रहा है, लेकिन फैब फ्रेगमेंट पे जो प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी का लेकिन जो एफ सी पोर्शन है वो सेकेंडरी एंटीबॉडी अटैच है. द थर्ड type of the ELISA is the sandwich ELISA. So sandwich ELISA, it is used for the detecting an antigen in the given sample. In this sandwich ELISA, the microtiter wells are initially coated with the monoclonal antibodies. Monoclonal antibodies are also called as the capture antibodies and raised against the antigen to be detected. जिस antigen को आपने detect करना है उसके लिए ये हम capture antibodies की तरह ये monoclonal antibodies काम करती है and followed by the addition of the sample. उसके बाद आप सैंपल यूज करोगे. तो एनी ट्रेसेस ऑफ एंटीजन इज डिटेक्टेड बाय एडिंग द प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी और मोनोक्लोनल एंटीबॉडी एंड फॉलोड बाय द एंजाइम कॉन्जुगेटेड सेकेंडरी एंटीबॉडी एंड अ क्रोमोजेनिक सबस्ट्रेट और बाय डायरेक्टली एडिंग एन एंजाइम कॉन्जुगेटेड प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी. तो इन दिस फॉर्मेट टू टाइप्स ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज वी हैव यूज. वन इज मोनोक्लोनल एंटीबॉडी and another is a primary antibody or a simple antibody. So this format requires the two antibodies which are specific for the different epitopes of antigen. Antigen ek hi hai lekin epitope dono ke liye different, means ki monoclonal ke liye alag aur jo antibody aap usme use kar rahe ho antigen ke detection ke liye sample se wo aapki alag hai, matlab wo alag nahi hai, sorry, uski bhi epitope alag. So two antibodies are normally referred to as a matched antibodies pair. One of the antibodies is coated on the surface of multi-well. इसमें से एक antibody जो multi-well plate है उसमें coated है and used as a capture antibody जैसे कि monoclonal antibody and to facilitate the immobilization of the antigen. The other antibody is conjugated and facilitate the detection of antigen. और another जो antibody है वो conjugated हो रही है और mainly detection of antigen के लिए facilitate कर रही है. Look at this picture. This is the immunosorbent material and this is used as a capture antibody as a monoclonal antibody or a recombinant monoclonal antibody coated microwells, then called as a capture antibody. After that, the target protein which have to be detected is used and it attaches to the monoclonal antibody at the different epitope are the different for the antigen. After that, we have to use then a secondary antibody or a primary antibody which is labeled with, they are simply called as antibody. Detection of antibody by this HRP or Stratish Peroxidase enzyme labeled antibody, same to same, TMB substrate, coloring product, and we have to detect with this ELISA reader. The last part is a competitive ELISA which have to be used as a direct, indirect, or sandwich ELISA, all types we can use. But main principle is that it is a type of a competitive ELISA in which either antigen, two types of antigens or two types of antibody both competes with each other, and especially we have to use it as a quantitative means. So in this variation of ELISA is used to quantitatively estimate the amount of protein, antigen metabolite and antibody in the given sample. Antigen and antibody, in this type of reaction first we have to produce antigen antibody complex. So antigen and antibodies are initially incubated so that they form an antigen antibody complex, and this mixture is then added to multiplier wells coated with the synthetic analog of antigen. Yahan pe synthetic analog of antigen hai, wahan par aap usko use kar rahe hain jisko aapne detect karna hai. Antigen antibody complex pehle se hi banana hai aur uske baad use microtiter wells mein dalna hai. Any free antibody binds to these antigen, koi bhi free antibody jo hai usse aake bind kare. So this complex is estimated by the enzyme conjugated secondary antibody by the chromogenic detection. So more the amount of antigen in the sample, lesser is the antibody available to bind to the microtiter wells. Simple as simple competitive ELISA. जैसे मान लो कि यहाँ पे कि एंटीजन अटैच है इम्यूनोसॉर्बेंट एसे पे और उस पर एंटीबॉडीज आके इम्यूनाइज हो गई. अब हमने किसी भी एंटीजन को डिटेक्ट करना है, हमने टू टाइप्स ऑफ एंटीजन यूज करे हैं, सम आर अनलेबल्ड एंड सम आर लेबल्ड. इनमें कंपटीशन होगा इस एंटीबॉडी पर अटैच होने के लिए, इस हिसाब से ये अटैच होगी. अगर मान लीजिए कि हमारे सैंपल में वो एंटीजन का अमाउंट कम है और दूसरा जो आप लेबल्ड वाला यूज कर रहे हो वो भी है लेकिन उसके कंपैरेटिवली अगर हमारे पेशेंट के सैंपल में जो हमें नहीं पता है कि कितना है वो कम है तो अटैचमेंट उसका ज्यादा होगा जिसका अमाउंट ज्यादा है. तो जो लेबल्ड वाले हैं एंटीजन वो ज्यादा एंटीबॉडी से अटैच होंगे और जो हमारे सैंपल में है अगर वो कम है, जो हमें पता नहीं है वो कम है, तो वो कम होना चाहिए। तो जब आप एंजाइम कॉन्जुगेटेड एंटीजन्स ज्यादा अटैच हो रहे हैं तो क्या होगा, सबस्ट्रेट डालने पर कलर ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस। इसके अपोजिट अगर ऐसा होता है कि सैंपल में एंटीजन्स ज्यादा है और आप जो यूज कर रहे हो वो कम है, कम मैं नहीं कहूंगी कि वो ज्यादा है, हम ठीक ऐसे जिसका हमें पता नहीं, तो जो आपके अनलेबल्ड वाले हैं वो ज्यादा अटैच होंगे एज कम्पेरेटिव टू जो अनलेबल्ड, मतलब जो लेबल्ड है उनके कम्पेरेटिव। तो ऐसी कंडीशन में क्या होगा, जो कलर प्रोड्यूस होगा वो क्या होगा, वो कम होगा। इससे हमें क्या पता चलता है, इससे हमें ये पता चलता है कम्पिटिटिव एलाइजा में कि कम्पीट करके जो विनर होता है उसके अपोजिट इनवर्सली प्रपोर्शनल, यानी कि अगर कलर ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस हो रहा है तो हमारे जो सैंपल में एंटीजन है वो कम है, वो कम है इसका मतलब अमाउंट कम। तो एब्जॉर्बेंस जिसका ज्यादा आएगा, जिस भी इस कम्पिटिटिव एलाइजा में जिसका एब्जॉर्बेंस ज्यादा आएगा, इसका मतलब जो आप डिटेक्ट करना चाह रहे हैं एंटीजन उसका अमाउंट कम है, इसकी वैल्यू कम आएगी। और अगर कलर हमारा लेस आ रहा है तो जो हम जिसको डिटेक्ट कर रहे हैं उसका अमाउंट ज्यादा है। इसको डिटेक्ट करने के लिए एलाइजा प्लेट रीडर से ग्राफ के थ्रू आप निकालते हैं, वो आपके लेवल पर इतना जरूरी नहीं है। आपको सिर्फ इतना पता होना चाहिए कि एलाइजा क्या है, उसका प्रिंसिपल क्या है, टाइप्स क्या है, और टाइप्स में एक आपको सिंपल ये डिफाइन करना आना चाहिए कि ये एलाइजा का ये टाइप है और ये जस्ट अ प्रिंसिपल, दिस इज ए कम्प्यूटेड एलाइजा, दिस इज द समरी ऑफ दैट टाइप ऑफ ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ एलाइजा, डायरेक्ट एलाइजा, एंटीजन, प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी विच इज एसोसिएटेड विद द कंजुगेट एंजाइम एंड सब्सट्रेट डालने के बाद कलर, ये डायरेक्ट। इनडायरेक्ट आपको पता है एंटीजन है प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडी, सेकेंडरी एंटीबॉडी विच इज कॉन्जुगेटेड इट प्रोड्यूसेस ए कलरिंग सब्सटेंस इनडायरेक्ट है। इन सैंडविच एलाइजा दिस कैप्चर एंटीबॉडी एज ए मोनोक्लोनल एंटीबॉडी, आफ्टर दैट एंटीजन इज अटैच्ड, देन प्राइमरी एंटीबॉडीज एंड द सब्सट्रेट ऑफ द सेकेंडरी एंटीबॉडीज आर यूज्ड एंड प्रोड्यूसेस द कलर सैंडविच बिकॉज द एंटीजन इज इन बिटवीन दिस two antibodies. So this is the slice of the bread and this is a butter. So it is called as a sandwich color. This is the competitive ELISA in which two antigens compete with each other with attachment to the antibody. And which if color is more, this antigen of interest is less, and when color is less, this antigen of interest is more. So this is used for this competitive ELISA. What is the application? So application is also important. So since ELISA can detect both antigens and antibody, it is useful tool for determining the serum antibody concentration. It has also found application in the food industry, like food allergens, milk, peanuts, walnuts, almonds, and eggs. It is not important for all of us, but the ELISA, which is used in the medicinal use, is a detection of mycobacterium antibodies in the tuberculosis, detection of hepatitis B marker in a serum, enterotoxin of E. coli in a feces, and detection of HIV antibodies in a blood sample. Then the immunoassays is used in the sports anti-doping laboratories to detect the test athletes in a blood sample for prohibited recombinant human growth hormone, and used for the many home pregnancy test immunoassays like human chorionic gonadotropin, then test to measure the CKMB level to assess the heart disease, then the measurement of insulin, PSA, PSA is a prostate specific antigen, it is a marker for the prostate carcinoma or as a cancer marker, okay, and various other hormones. Then the advantages of ELISA, you all know, it is a very sensitive technique, no radiation hazards as compared to the RIA, reagents are cheap with a long shelf life, qualitatively as well as quantitatively we have to measure these types of samples, and the ELISA can be used most types of the biological samples like plasma, serum, urine, cell, etc. What is the disadvantage? First disadvantage is the monoclonal antibody which have to use in a sandwich ELISA can be used as a mesh bag. It is costly. So monoclonal antibodies can cost more than the polyclonal antibodies. Second one is that we have to use negative controls. Sometimes these negative controls may indicate the positive results if blocking solution is ineffective. अगर blocking solution ineffective है, इसमें actually दो step होती है, एक washing की step होती है और एक blocking की step होती है. Washing की जो step होगी वो इसलिए use करते हैं जो unbound form है वो वहां से remove हो, इसलिए हम उसको wash कर देते हैं. और blocking solution हम इसलिए use करते हैं ताकि जो reaction हमारी हो गई है वो वहीं stop हो जाए, उसे हम blocking solution कहते हैं. इसके अलावा क्या है, यहाँ पे जो सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट और एक डिसएडवांटेज है ये कि एंजाइम सब्सट्रेट की जो रिएक्शन है वो बहुत शॉर्ट टर्म है, तो जो कलर है वो बहुत शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन के लिए प्रोड्यूस होगा और उसके बाद उसका कलर फेड होगा, तो अगर आप उसको विद टाइम रीड ना नहीं करेंगे तो आपके रिजल्ट्स अफेक्टेड होंगे. व्हाट इज द कंक्लूजन? ELISA इज अ नॉवल टेक्निक यूजफुल इन डिटेक्टिंग क्वालिटेटिवली एंड क्वांटिटेटिवली एन एंटीजन और एंटीबॉडी प्रेजेंट इन द गिवन बायोलॉजिकल सैंपल. Besides its disadvantages, the technique is being widely used in diagnostic and drug screening. Chromogenic detection methods used in the ELISA is convenient and sensitive for any NC and is hazardous. Thank you so much.